Everyone, it's Morgan Yates, and this week's video is gonna be another easy meals video, guest starring Giselle, as always, my lead chef these days. All these meals are a little bit winter inspired, things that will be really hearty and warm and cozy for those chili days. So our recipes today are going to be tonight showing you our favorite chili of the moment. Also, we're gonna do a homemade chicken noodle soup, a delicious, flavorful tomato basil soup. Is basil in it? And lastly, a kind of fall but wintry harvest salad. All these recipes are just packed with flavor, packed with nutrients. Tonight's recipe, what?
There was basil.
There was basil. I knew there was basil in it. All right, come here. Your turn. Ingredients we're gonna need for today. Come here. Oh, Giselle's looking so shy.
Dog, I don't wanna talk. I'm just gonna hide behind you.
So, ingredients for today's recipe. Your meat of choice, we are using this 99% lean ground turkey breast. Funny story here, the whole reason this was like a creative recipe is because we've been packing it with not only tomatoes, so we have some fresh tomatoes, we've just been using like whatever is left on hand, as well as a can of crushed tomatoes, black beans, kidney beans, whatever beans you want. But again, what made this creative-ish was that we've been making this packed with mushrooms, a ton of kale, was there something else? All of which we just realized had gone bad. So, taco seasoning, you get chili seasoning, but if you shop at Trader Joe's, honestly, it's the same thing. Some garlic, an onion. What is step one?
Chop up this stuff. Oh, cook the turkey.
All right, I'm gonna cook the turkey. Can you chop? I got a request because I mentioned on Instagram that I was potentially gonna do this video, and some people asked for some vegetarian options. You can absolutely do this without the meat. We also have carrots on hand. We were thinking about adding some carrots to this, but we're gonna put that in the chicken noodle soup. Also, what's my outfit? I have no idea. Get in there. This is also we're actually gonna add the onion while we're browning the meat for extra flavor. Garlic.
Chili powder. Lots of it.
Really good chili, quite spicy.
And cumin. I need the can of tomatoes, honestly.
Yeah.
All these fresh tomatoes.
All right, we did a little tomato swap because we already had a bunch of tomatoes, so just had the smaller can on hand. Add the tomatoes and the liquid, but when you add the beans, we strain those. At what point do people add the mushrooms and the kale?
I would add
because that's the actual recipe here.
I would add them in the beginning.
With the meat?
Yeah.
The kale?
Or after the meat cooks.
Beans number one.
I'm gonna strain the beans though.
Oh, kidding.
Like you said you were gonna do.
Giselle just told me there's a secret ingredient I never knew about. A little bit of honey. Almost done. This is really like a empty the pantry meal, you guys. Like, here are the toppings of tonight. We had some leftover cheddar cheese. These were all the salvageable chives, so don't look over there. We're gonna have some sour cream. Oh, did you wanna add spinach or nah?
Ooh.
A little bit or nah? Nah. If we have red onion on hand, we'll chop that up. Key takeaway is that if you have some random leftover veggies, chili can be a great empty the fridge kind of meal. If you just have some beans, which I feel like people usually have beans in their pantry, you just gotta buy some meat and some seasoning. Giselle's looks cute with the whipped cream. Sour cream, taste test.
Oh,
it's hot.
Yum,
it's
hot.
That's so good.
Mm-hmm.
What's the flavor? I always thought you're putting like cinnamon in it or something.
Cumin.
Is it just cumin and like honey?
Do you put cinnamon in it last time? I put nutmeg in it last time.
That's it for the first recipe. Stay tuned to something a little more creative next.
Wait, what? I forgot what a Negroni tastes like.
Is it good?
It's so good.
Tonight, it's also happy hour.
Happy hour with
Giselle.
incredible. Gotta go through the jungle. Right?
I forgot how good those were too. It's also snack time. I'm freaking starving.
Probably because we use good ice too. I don't like the fridge ice.
Giselle has a vendetta against the fridge ice.
It's terrible.
I've never had a problem. On the menu tonight, we are making Giselle's chicken noodle soup. I grew up in a family where the only chicken noodle soup I ever ate was the Progresso can.
Campbell's.
Yeah, you're right. I've since been enlightened because Giselle one time recently when I was sick made this really great chicken noodle soup and we've been craving it. Coming through.
That is gorgeous.
We are using a rotisserie chicken. Our noodle of today, we've been really liking the little shells. That's kind of what we've made every single time. We tried the bonzo ones because we wanted to do a little gluten-free moment. I thought it tasted fine, so I recommend Giselle didn't like it. She's very particular. And then our veggies going in, we have a bunch of carrots, we have onion, a bunch of parsley, a bunch of celery. Someone's been through something.
I need the zest.
Garlic. So if you don't have parsley or you don't spend on parsley, we used this recently as like a garnish as well. The parsley's really just as a garnish. And then a good cracker to dip
the
in
best
there.
Cracker.
These are so good. These little crackers, if you see them, get them. Don't look at my nails though.
I need to get these.
What's step one? Put me to work. Bella is such a chef. She has like her use bowl and her waste bowl. Ask me if I've ever thought about doing a waste bowl. All right, so we're chopping up our celery, carrots, and onion. What's the directions here?
I'm shredding the rotisserie chicken. I like to do the breast.
What do you do with the rest of it?
Sometimes I eat it.
Okay.
Or if I'm like really trying to make a high quality soup, I'll use everything to make the bones to make a chicken broth.
Yeah, you did that one time.
Yeah, but it takes a long time.
Yeah, she extra. All right, go hard on the pepper, everyone. If you have chicken broth, you can of course use that. We don't have that, but we're going more economical route anyway, because we had this on hand. What is this? We added 4 cups of water, our little mirepoix, and then toss a bunch of that in there. Oh, a lot.
And then give that a stir. And then we add bay leaves too.
We added lots of pepper, but no salt, right?
With the chicken bouillon salty.
Where can you buy that? Just any kind of grocery
store? Yeah.
Sometimes we'll put the noodles in just like to the mixture going on over here and they'll cook in that and that's great. However, we don't have enough people here to eat all of this in one setting. It doesn't always make for the best leftovers. Keeping it all together, the noodles kind of soak up a ton of the liquid. So we're gonna boil the pasta separately and then just kind of scoop out our soup and add the noodles all together when we're serving. And that way we can store them separately and have it good as new when we're ready for leftovers. That's just a tip. A little acid, juice of half a lemon or a whole lemon?
I'm gonna do the whole lemon.
Mm-mm-mm. It's not gonna end up tasting lemony, just makes for a complex flavor. All right, so that's about how much went in ours. Our pasta has cooked, we strain that out, and then our soup is ready. The noodle first approach. Top with some parsley.
Start.
I feel like everything in this video is like a simple idea, but at least for me, I shouldn't know how to make any of them. Today, we're making a really delicious tomato soup, some garlicky basil in there. I didn't know, Giselle, what did you just say?
Oh, I could add a carrot to cut the acid.
I don't know. I don't know if you need to do that. Every time we do this, we have some different tomatoes, usually because we just have some on hand that need to get used or they're gonna go bad. So we've used heirloom ones, some like little cherry ones, just like whatever assortment. Today we got a bunch of little tomatoes on the vine. What are these called?
Campari
tomatoes. And then these were just like your big fresh normal tomatoes. I don't know. As well as we're gonna roast up one red pepper just for like an additional added flavor there, and then a shallot and some garlic. This is pretty easy. We're just gonna put this in the oven until everything is looking nice and roasty. All right, we're prepping then the garlic. So I'll add a little bit of oil on there. Mmm. Salt and pepper. And then she's chopped up all of the tomatoes, just our pepper in half. And then the garlic's going on there. And this is kind of it. So that roasts until it's looking all nice and charred up, right?
Exactly.
Giselle says it should be 450, but we're too impatient for it to heat.
Bye.
Goodbye. All right, it's been probably like 30 minutes, would you say?
Yeah, 45 minutes.
45 minutes, I don't know. We really have no idea, so I think you should just look at it. We're very bad about like measuring actual amounts of things, if you haven't noticed, but I think you should trust yourself to just taste things as you go. Trust your intuition, and you know, you can't really mess things up too badly, but.
I don't know why I don't have bigger tongues, I think they're dirty.
Why are you using that? You just use a spatula. Oh, Giselle got these little culinary tweezer things.
Not meant for what I'm doing.
I don't know, yeah.
So, we are going to pair this, I forgot to say, but with a grilled cheese. The last time we did a really good, like, three cheese blend. It was hearty mozzarella and like unexpected cheddar, right? That was also just what we had on hand. So again, we're always just trying to make use of things so that they don't get wasted. So right now we have still some shredded mozzarella cheese. We have like shredded unexpected cheddar. Oh, we have sharp white cheddar too. I prefer sourdough bread. We're gonna put a little bit of butter on a pan on this like cast iron, right?
But for the soup, everything is going in here. You can put it in a blender if you don't have a fancy little emulsifier, is that what it's called? Emulsion blender, I don't know. A bunch of basil, fresh off the plant. Oh, more and more.
I don't know how I'm gonna squeeze that out without burning my hand, you know?
Yeah, how did you do it last time?
I had gloves last time.
Maybe hold a paper towel and do it? Running a cup of water. A broth is also great here, a little veggie broth. My sourdough is going on the pan. You don't need a cast iron pan, you can just put it on whatever, or you just put it in the toaster. Now this is our fancy device.
Definitely needs more flavor.
Needs more flavor?
Yeah.
Maybe a little more garlic powder or something?
I think I put nutritional yeast in it last time.
Oh, what's in there? Let's stir in that garlic powder. Maybe a little more pepper. So this is how we wing things.
Trapped
me. Well, what's a little crispy crust? Today we're going gourmet with the five cheese deluxe blends. Just a trace amount of unexpected shit. Thin layer of parm. That is burnt.
What?
I gotta take it out, but the cheese is melted.
We have so much other cheese.
Sorry for this fan, it drives me crazy. Tell me guys, the bread is burnt. Okay, what'd you add to this?
I added garlic salt, basil, black pepper.
It's not even getting melty. Mm-hmm. I think we should just, yeah.
That's not terrible.
Okay, could be worse.
Here.
There. Here's what the soup is looking like. Giselle added some croutons that we got for another recipe tomorrow. I think she can put some goat cheese on, because we also have that for tomorrow's recipe, which will be delicious. Some people add other creams and things, right?
That's gonna be good. Yum.
Chili flakes for some heat.
I'm so excited.
Mmm. The goat cheese is a nice touch.
Mm-hmm.
Just like melts away in there. Okay, let's try the crispy grilled cheese.
Oops.
Mmm. It's good. How would it be bad?
Mmm.
Mmm. Mmm. Mm-hmm. Wow. This is better than last time.
Mm-hmm. Hey, pretty squash.
Welcome to our lunch today. Will give a little shout out. Not sponsored at all. I do primarily use, well, it depends. I have several pans I use. They're all nonstick, but I do really love the Our Place pans. This is like their perfect pot, which we made the soup in last night. It's the only reason I'm toasting these in here, or just their Always pan. So I'll have them linked from time to time. They do run a sale. I just feel like of all my nonstick stuff, these have held up the best. Giselle is making our dressing, except that it's pretty heavily based on this Trader Joe's balsamic and fig dressing. It was just balsamic, wine vinegar, fig paste and olive oil. Oh, there's already honey in this. Garlic, sea salt, whatever. But anyways, we're just adding some extra flavor because we tasted it and we felt like it could use a little bit more acid in the salad as a whole the last time we did this. So we got some lemon juice, some honey. I'm toasting up for a crunch factor. Some almonds back here. Okay, yeah, and those are done. I did this last time. They go from like, you know, nothing's happening to like, oh, it's burnt. So what is going in our little harvest salad today is some squash that we are roasting up, which you already saw. Our base is gonna be kale and arugula. I feel like those are good greens for this type of situation, but use whatever you want. If you like apple, then you could chop that up and add it in here. I feel like that would be a really good addition, but I just really don't like apples for some reason. We got this little raisin blend for some color and just some added flavor and texture. We are doing some pomegranate seeds. We got some croutons. I'm not a big fan of those, so I don't know if I'm gonna include them.
It's good. It's good, right?
An optional choice, you can de-stem your kale. Oh, I thought it was your trash bowl again. We're gonna let our kale soak a little bit.
I'm supposed to massage kale.
How are you gonna massage it? You're gonna soften it up.
I'm just gonna toss it around, rough it up a bit.
Everything is ready to go. I think this would be really good with like some grilled chicken, really bring it full like sweet green status. However, we didn't have that.
I'm just going vegetarian.
Yeah.
Just put like a bed of green.
A bed of greens would be good. Oh, that was a smart idea. Also, the squash is so good. We're just eating it. We're like, this could be just a snack.
Uh-oh. What? Looks like someone touched the squash and touched the white towel because there's turmeric on it.
Looks like that would be me, I guess. I didn't know how to do that. All right, so here is what the salad is looking like. So we are gonna eat this. If you decide to make any of these recipes, feel free to tag me or DM me a photo. I always love, don't I?
Oh yeah.
Every time someone says, I want to show it to them because I get very excited. I hope you enjoy all of these hearty little meals.